and welcome to Reaching Out. I'm your host, Kim Carey. This is the time of the year we celebrate a movement that started over 40 years ago on college campuses and universities, and it's now worldwide. That celebration is Earth Day. Joining me to discuss how we can improve our environment is Kathleen Francois, Executive Director for Greening Detroit, and Steve Litz, Operations Manager for Michigan Green Team. Welcome to Reaching Out.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you so much.
Very nice.
Very, very good. How is Greening Detroit raising awareness for Earth Day?
Well, we do what we call media sponsoring, and I think this year we'll probably hit about our 700th or 800th that has happened. Now, I've only been around for about 3.5 years, but we do event after event, pushing out press releases, letting people know through social media. We put it on the site. We have media partners all over the place. We send that information out, and it gets popcorned out through our media partners, through our newsletters. LinkedIn especially, we have a lot of really great relationships through LinkedIn and through Facebook and that type of thing. And then, of course, through direct emails, talking to the people that we know, and, of course, the people that are on the site.
Right, which brings me to you, Steve.
Yes.
Tell us about all the exciting upcoming events for Earth Day.
Well, for Earth Day, of course, the Michigan Green Team here in Rochester is putting on their 12th annual Earth Day Fest. It's going to be April 21st, 22nd, and 23rd. And it's something that came out of the passion of John Batdorf, who's the event organizer. And I met John about 6 years ago, being an exhibitor at the event, and just really loved his passion. I love the concept. I love the organizations that come together, and not realizing it was as big as it was. So from there, I wound up joining up as a volunteer and have come up through the ranks and done a variety of jobs for
him.
So
what were you promoting?
At that time, I was working for a local installer of electric vehicle charging systems.
Okay.
And so that was in its infancy back in 2011. And of course, as we know now, electric cars are abundant throughout the country, right?
My husband has one.
Yeah. If you can imagine, there's actually there's about 35 electric cars that are being produced today. Mm. And a lot of people aren't aware of them, but each car company has plans to bring a great number of them to the marketplace within the next 10 years. So it was a great growing business and opportunity for me to be in, and I still am.
That's very, very good. So let's talk about Connect Cafe.
Okay.
What's that about?
Well, Connect Cafe actually is something that Kathleen's going to be in charge of for the organization.
Okay.
It's a event that we have every year where we invite speakers that come out to talk about healthy living topics. Health care is a big topic that comes up every year. Dr. Nandy was with us last year.
Oh, that's great.
Yes. But excellent. And so this year there's a whole new list of speakers. And Kathleen, if you'd like to mention a couple of them.
Well, the one that really excites me, I actually had an issue with running through a spray that somebody was putting on a lawn back in Virginia Beach. And it was a pesticide. And Jeff Copeland, who owns A1 Organic Lawn Care, is going to be talking about the unknown risks of what can happen when you're putting inorganic things.
Breast cancer.
Absolutely, absolutely. I almost died just by running past this stuff. While these guys had masks on, I had no idea. And about a half mile away, I'm hived up, and ambulances had to be called, and the whole thing. Because I happened to run by, a lot of people don't recognize that if you're killing weeds, if you're killing bugs, there's a reason why that particular chemical is killing.
And so you're killing us.
You're killing yourself, and it can really be a great cause. I'd like to see some research done on the long-term effects on what's going on with our children as well. So it's, for me, it's a personal thing. I'm really excited to hear what he has to say on that. And then the Gerald Hasbacher, who is part of the Sierra Club committee and really knows a lot about climate change. We won't call it global warming. I think it's really a climate change.
Yeah.
He's going to go very in depth on what it is that's happening for us and why we see things blooming a little earlier and you know, the results of what's going to happen long term.
Tell us about all the music and live entertainment we can expect at the Earth Day Festival.
Well, we're very fortunate to have a lady by the name of Jennifer Kintzer, who is locally known. She has a voice studio in Rochester. And so she has helped bring up a lot of great talent in the local level. And she has been our program manager for the last couple of years. So she arranges 3 days of live entertainment, both from the school level with children to up-and-coming artists to established artists. We've got Stony Creek High School is coming out, and they're going to actually do a musical selection from Sister Act, which is a musical that they're going to be putting on in the next few weeks. The Pistons Performing Arts Center, which is a very energetic hip-hop singing group, and they come out every year, and they're a real crowd pleaser. But we have Leah Catalo will be out there, who is a local favorite, a young girl of 14 years old. Mm-hmm. She's been a recording artist, a performer in the local area. We have Steve Taylor, who's an established artist also, acoustic artist that's out there too.
That's nice.
Oh, it's wonderful. Mm-hmm. We're going to have Kensington K-Rock, which is the kids program from Kensington Church, is going to be out there. Just so many great opportunities to come out and see and support local talent. And it happens all 3 days. So come on out for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday to see it. And of course, the schedule's on the website for MI Earth Day Fest here in Rochester.
But before we close out, Steve, tell us about the fan club membership and how folks can get involved with that.
Absolutely. So the Michigan Green Team is the organization that puts on the Earth Day Fest locally. They also put on several other events throughout the year, and they've really brought together the community of companies that offer green services, healthy services, and products. And so if they go to the Michigan Green Team website, they can actually sign on and become a member and enjoy the discounts and the connection with all these products and local companies that are out there that can help offer them a healthier lifestyle to live. And that's kind of really our tagline with the event itself. Mm-hmm. With the what we're looking for people to do is come out and explore green and healthy living at one of the largest festivals on the planet right now, which is happening right here in Rochester. We're at a new location, so I just wanted to make sure I mentioned that. We're at Third and Water, which is over near the east of Rochester Road between the Rochester Mills and the fire station. But there's a large property there that allows us to grow even larger this year. So we're looking at having 150 exhibitors, plus 5-6 aisleways of products, of healthcare services. We have massage therapy people out there that will be giving free massages. There's going to be a lot of learning opportunities at the Connect Cafe. We also have the sound stage, which is being sponsored by Imagine Theater. They're one of our big sponsors. DT Energy is also. We've got Lole, which we talked about, which is a women's not only fitness clothing, but active lifestyle clothing. They're one of our big sponsors.
Now, I would be interested in
that. You would look good in that. You would. Smart Transportation is out there. McKellar is our promotional marketing company. So they do all the t-shirts and all the promotional items. They're a great supporter of our event out there. And of course, Greening Detroit is one of our media sponsors out there. So we're gonna have Fox 2 News, which will come out and do interviews throughout the 3 days. WNIC Radio is gonna be also promoting us out there too. So it's really a great event. And also some of the things that keeping to the true mission of Earth Day Fest, we also are going to have a drive-up, drop-off recycling center. Homeowners that want to dispose of small household appliances, electronics, office equipment, batteries, things like that, we're going to have different companies that specialize in that area will be collecting those recyclables and being able to put them back to good use. And even I found out that the Stony Creek lacrosse team is taking recycled shoes, sports shoes and cleats, slightly used dress shoes, and they're going to take those in donation and recycle those also as a project that they're doing this year too. So it's really a heartfelt mission from everybody out there. It's a great community event supported by all, and like I mentioned, it's the 12th year. So, you know, we've gone and we've done great things. We've had smaller venues. You know, whatever, you know, the feeling of, or pulse of the community is at that time. But one thing always stands true, and that's the fact that greener, healthier living is what most people are interested in knowing about and living every day.
That's right. That's right.
That recycling drop-off is one of my absolute favorites, because you can really get the kids involved with it, too, and get your spring cleaning done all at one time and pile it all into the car and show the kids firsthand. Mm-hmm. And then the K through 12, the United States Green Building Council art contest.
Yes.
K through 5, including homeschooled kids, which I love. Anybody can be a part of that as well, and that's on the site too.
You guys have a lot going on, and I'm so glad that you came in to let us know about the upcoming festivities for Earth Day. It sounds like it's going to be outstanding.
It will.
Outstanding. So thank you both.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right. Remember, Earth Day is every day. Let's keep our earth green and clean. It's the only one we've got. From all of us at Reaching Out, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.